A philosopher once said a wise man proportions his belief to the evidence. That's true. I want to encourage Irene Matta, also known as Judith Matta, to proportion her belief to the overwhelming evidence that the doctrine of the aerial toll houses is part of the teaching of Orthodox Christianity. It's in the lives of our saints. It's in the teaching of the Holy Fathers. It's in the iconography and church services. So last night I watched a video with Irene, and she attacked the doctrine of the aerial toll houses. And when I watched the video, I thought to myself, does she really believe what she's saying, or is she lying? Because it's hard for me to believe that a person could be so blind. Now, I don't have proof she read the book by St. Anthony's Monastery on the toll houses, which was released in 2017. It's over 1,000 pages. If you haven't read it, Irene, you should, because it deals with you on pages 875 to 877. It refutes you, and it proves that the doctrine of the aerial toll houses is part of Orthodox Christian teaching. It's in dogmatic theology volumes. Again, it's in the lives of the saints, the fathers, the iconography, and the church services. So Irene suppresses crucial amounts of information. She suppresses so much information. She's guilty of the fallacy of exclusion, also known as cherry picking, and the fallacy of suppressed evidence. What are you going to do, Irene, with all this overwhelming evidence proving that you are wrong? You're just simply wrong, and you need to adjust your perspective to correspond to patristic material. The book by St. Anthony's Monastery, by the way, is called The Departure of the Soul According to the Teaching of the Orthodox Church. This woman was refuted in 2017 when this book came out. It also refutes Lazar Pahalo. Now, she called Father Seraphim Rose, Seraphim Rose, which is disrespectful. He was a priest in good standing. He was never deposed, so it's proper to refer to him as Father Seraphim Rose. Now, she does later in the video call him Father Seraphim Rose. She slanders him, though, when she calls him or accuses him of being a Gnostic. That's slanderous. Whenever anyone claims that the toll houses is Gnostic or pagan, they're committing the fallacy of false cause, non causa pro causa. And Irene, I want to ask you the question. Can you prove with primary source documentation that the Orthodox Church itself believes that Father Seraphim Rose was a Gnostic? Cite me primary source information. No, you're just giving your ill-informed opinion. She said Elder Frim is not consonant with the Holy Fathers. That's just simply not true. You read the book by St. Anthony's Monastery and you will see that on the topic of the aerial toll houses, Elder Frim was in perfect harmony with the fathers and saints of our church. You read the book by St. Anthony's Monastery and you will see who is telling you the truth. She said you can write huge tomes 2 or 3 inches thick. It doesn't mean anything. It's nonsense. End quote. Well, first of all, she doesn't prove that the information in the book by St. Anthony's Monastery is nonsense. She makes the accusation that you can write huge tomes 2 or 3 inches thick and it's nonsense, but she doesn't prove that the information in the book is nonsense. I don't have any proof she actually read the book, but her statement that you can write huge tome 2 or 3 inches thick indicates to me that she's familiar with it. Again, I don't have proof, so I just wanted to mention that as well. She claimed that the toll house's teaching says we are judged by demons. That's not true. This accusation is dealt with in the book. The correct teaching is that we are judged by God. As we go through the aerial toll houses, the demons accuse us and they slander us. They present our bad deeds, but God is the one who does the judging. And I do want to say here that the book by St. Anthony's Monastery made me love Orthodoxy more, and it showed me how merciful and loving God is. If you die having received communion on the day of your death, you're going to shoot through the toll houses. This is the mercy of God. Okay, this is a great teaching about the aerial toll houses. God is merciful, and the angels guard us. She said the so-called revelations of the fathers were composed by originators of corrupt heresies under the influence of demons and their fantasies. She doesn't give proof for this. say, false accusations. You know, the revelations were given by God, theoria, spiritual vision. And by the way, the Tollhouse's doctrine, again, does not come from Gnosticism or paganism. It comes from theoria, spiritual vision, which was given by God to our saints. So again, she's guilty of the fallacy of false cause. Now, she said the true God is not some dark angels. Well, that's a straw man argument, because we who accept the doctrine of the Aerial Tollhouses don't claim that the true God is some dark angel. So you need to get it right, Irene. Now, she claims that the story of Basil the New and Theodora is a myth. She calls it Gnostic. And she said it's, quote, used by Fathers Rose and Ephraim followers. Well, yes, they used it, but they're not the only ones in Orthodoxy who used it. The story of Theodora and Basil the New was accepted by St. Theophan the Recluse, St. Nikolai Velimirovic, St. Justin Popovic, Father Mitrofan of Konevsky Island Monastery. His book was endorsed by the Educational Committee of the Holy Synod of the Russian Orthodox Church in 1882. It was accepted by St. The story of Basil the New and Theodora was accepted by St. Dmitry of Rostov. He records it. Hieromartyr Daniel Sysoev of Moscow, the Holy Synod of the Russian Orthodox Church outside Russia, and Elder Cleopa of Romania. Okay. I can name 123 saints who taught the trial of the soul after death. In ancient times, St. Anthony of the Great held this view. Closer to our times, St. John Maximovich. Okay. So, yes, I can name 123 saints who believed in the trial of the soul after death, and 39 elders, clergy, monastics, and theologians whose writings or lives refer to the trial of the soul at the hour of death. Now, read the book, you'll see who's telling you the truth, the book by St. Anthony's Monastery, that is. And if I have to make any corrections, I'll put it below in the description box. Have a good day.